Hello students, welcome to biology class. Now in the previous classes we discussed about human reproduction. Now let's begin with a new chapter, that is chapter number 4, reproductive health. Now we have already discussed about health and diseases. In that chapter we have studied about the definition of health. Do you remember what is that? Can you just recollect what is health? Health can be defined as a state of physical, mental and social well-being of a person. Now let's see, if that is a definition for health, what is a definition for reproductive health? What would be the definition? Can anybody try? Okay, now let's see, what is the definition? According to the World Health Organization, reproductive health means, reproductive health means total well-being in all aspects of reproduction, that is physical aspect, emotional aspect, behavioral aspect and social aspect of a person. Now when we say physical aspect, what's the meaning of that? What is the physical aspect of reproduction? Means the reproductive organs. It is the health of the reproductive organs. Then emotional aspect. A person should be emotionally fit and fine. Then only we can say that he is reproductively healthy. The same way, behavior. The reproductive behavior. How a person behaves with his partner. That is very, very important. And even in a society, how a person behaves. So these are the different aspects of reproduction. So we can define reproductive health as the total well-being in all aspects of reproduction, that is physical, emotional, behavioral and social. Hope it's clear? Right. Now let's see, what are the problems that we face in the aspect of reproduction, and what are the strategies by which that we have to follow by which we can solve these problems. So some of the India was amongst the first countries in the world to initiate the program of family planning. I hope you must have heard about family planning, isn't it? Hum do, hamare do. That is a slogan for family planning. And this was introduced very early, that is right in 1951. And India was one of the first countries to implement, one among the first countries to implement the family planning. And why India must have thought about this family planning right in 1951, that is immediately after our independence. You know, what must be the reason? Because of population explosion. Okay, now, so that is the India was the first country or among the first countries, many countries in that one among the first countries to initiate the program of family planning. Now, in a society, reproductive health is very, very important. It is forms a crucial part of general health of a society. Now, after family planning, recently or after some years, the government realized the need of certain special programs to take care of the reproductive aspects or the different aspects of reproduction. So, I don't know whether you know it or no, your grand parents, if you ask them, they must have had their deliveries at home. In olden days, it was at home that most of the deliveries took place, and the pregnant lady never used to go to hospital or any healthcare center. And it was midwives, there were no doctors who take care of this process of delivery. It was midwife system. Okay, there were certain ladies who were experienced or experts in that field, and they will be called when a lady begins with the labor pain. So there were many complications associated with that. You know that nowadays in hospitals, some deliveries will not be normal deliveries. They have to go for cesarean sections, right? So at home, that cannot be done. And that was not under the supervision of a doctor. So it was done by certain experienced old ladies. And so related with that, there were many deaths. That is, the mother immediately after giving birth, she may die. Sometimes the child dies. So there were many complications. So realizing all these, now the government has initiated several programs. And one such program is the RCH program. Now, what is RCH program? It is the Reproductive and Child Health Care Program. Very important. You may get for exam RCH. Expand RCH. RCH is Reproductive and Child Health Care Program. Now, as per this program, there were certain aims, or this program was initiated or implemented, keeping in mind certain goals. Now, what were the goals? The two main goals. First one was creating awareness among the people about various reproduction related aspects. Creating awareness. People should know the importance of going to a hospital or going to a doctor, consult a doctor whenever they have certain problems related with the reproductive organs or with the reproduction. That is, when a lady conceives, if she has certain problems, she must consult a doctor, right? So create that awareness among the people, those people who are illiterate, especially in villages or tribal people, they have certain misconceptions or myths regarding this process of reproduction. So they hesitate to go to a doctor when they conceive. So they try to be at home. So we must create awareness among the people about this reproduction related aspects. The second important goal was to provide facilities and support for building up a reproductively healthy society. What does it mean? How can we provide facilities? That means we have to have a proper infrastructure. That is, we should have buildings which can serve as a hospital or a healthcare center where this people with reproduction related problems can approach, wherein they can approach a doctor, wherein they can consult a doctor and take proper treatment if they have certain diseases in their reproductive organs or certain problems associated with their reproduction. Okay, so that is the second. So the two main aims of RCH program are: the first one, creating awareness among people about various reproduction related aspects. Second one, providing facilities and support for building up a reproductively healthy society. And question which you can expect for your exam: what are the aims of, or what are the tasks of RCH program? Hope it's clear. Right. Now, we move on to the next. Now, government has taken certain measures to help the people, to create awareness among the people. So how this awareness was created, can be created? One way is with the help of audio, visual and print media. What's the meaning of that? Through radios or through TV programs or through newspaper or magazines. All these, we can create awareness among the people. That is one method. Second method is, family members and close relatives are involved in creating this awareness. That is, the parents should help the children to know about their reproductive organs, to know about the changes which happen during the adolescent age, okay, the sexual behaviors, all that. Even sometimes relatives can help in creating this awareness. Another third one is sex education. By educating the children in school itself about the various reproduction related aspects, by creating awareness by imparting proper knowledge about the reproductive organs, the proper knowledge about diseases that affect the reproductive organs or the changes which take place due to the hormonal changes which take place, or the secondary sexual characteristics, all these. So in school, many of you, when you attain puberty Right, there were many changes that took place in your body. So some of you were very much scared when the first time when you got the periods or your menstrual cycle started. But some students, they knew what it is and all that. So they were not very much scared of that. So by imparting proper knowledge through sex education, we can create an awareness among the youth. So sex education, so keeping this in mind, sex education was introduced in schools to create awareness. Then another one is proper information about reproductive organs. So many a times friends or people who don't know, they give wrong information about the reproductive organs. So they get wrong information from the media, from their friends, or sometimes from their peer group. So we should impart a proper knowledge at the level of 8th standard or 9th standard, so that children themselves will know. Okay, so here the teachers play an important role. So you all have studied about the human reproduction, the structure of reproductive organs, school itself, isn't it? So, and now we have studied in detail little more. So as you grow up, according to your age, you will be imparted with proper knowledge about the reproductive organs and the process of reproduction. So in the last chapter, you studied about the menstrual cycle. You first we studied, discussed about the reproductive organs. Then we discussed about the process of gametogenesis. Then we discussed about the menstrual cycle. Then we discussed about the process of fertilization, then implantation, and then embryonic development till how a baby is born. Isn't it? So this is very much required. So when the children, see, now you all know what it is. What is, if somebody tells you something about reproduction, you as bio students very well know what it is. You know very well about menstrual cycle. You know very well about the hormones. Okay. You know very well about many of the aspects of reproduction. Now, by the time you complete, we complete this chapter, you will be thorough with the rest part also. Okay. So, that is proper information about reproductive organs. Second one, adolescence. Adolescence means the period between, what is adolescence? The period between childhood and adulthood. So what are the changes that take place during this adolescence period? Now, what are the safe and hygienic sexual practices? You should know, you should have a proper information about sexually transmitted diseases so that you can take proper care of that. Then all these will help the people of adolescent age group to lead a healthy life. Okay, now the last point which the government wants to the people to know is educating young couples and youth of marriageable age group, means the people who are in the age group of 21 to 30 who are not yet married, about birth control measures, how to control birth, how to space children, when to have children and how many children you should have, what should be the space between the first child and the second child. All these can be decided by a couple if they have a proper knowledge about birth control measures. Okay, then care of pregnant mother, how to take care of a pregnant lady when a lady conceives. What are the care? What all care we should take? What all should be given to that pregnant mother so that she gives birth to a healthy child? Then postnatal care means after the birth, what are the what care we should give to the child or the baby? Then etc. would help couples to have healthy families of desired sizes. So now the couple can decide how many children they can have. If they want to have only two children, there are many methods by which you can prevent further pregnancies. Okay. And if you want to have children, a gap between the first child and the second child, then also you can go for certain birth control measures. You can use certain contraceptives by which you can space your children. Okay, so these are some of the measures taken by government. Hope you got it. Okay, now we will move on to the next. What are the steps to attain reproductive health? So as I've already told you, in order to have a proper reproductive healthy society, we need to have a strong infrastructure facilities. Strong infrastructure in the sense, we should have proper hospitals with expert doctors who can handle the reproduction related aspects. Okay, then second point, professional expertise means who are the experts in the field of reproduction. They are the doctors, okay, sexologists or gynecologists, okay. So we should have professional expertise. Then material support. What is required for an operation? We need to have, see, only infrastructure doesn't make a hospital. Hospital requires many other equipments, right? So that is what is called as material support. So these are the three major steps to attain reproductive health. Which are the three steps? One is strong infrastructural facilities. Second one, professional expertise. Third one, material support. So these are required to provide medical assistance and care during pregnancy, delivery, abortions, menstrual problems and so on. So many of you are facing menstrual problems, okay, irregular periods and all that. So what you have to do, you have to approach or consult a proper gynecologist who can lead you to have a regular cycle, okay. So now, another important test which is used to detect the sex of the fetus. When the baby is in the mother's womb itself, we can know whether the baby is a boy baby or a girl baby, right? That process is called as amniocentesis. Now, what is amniocentesis? It is a fetal sex determination test based on the chromosomal pattern in the amniotic fluid surrounding the embryo. When the baby is growing inside the mother's womb, okay, the baby is growing inside the mother's womb, around the baby there will be a membrane which is called as an amniotic membrane, and inside that there will be a fluid which is called as an amniotic fluid. So it is inside this amniotic fluid that the baby will be moving. So by taking a little bit of amniotic fluid, there will be certain cells of the baby in the amniotic fluid, okay. So by studying the chromosomal pattern in the amniotic fluid, we can determine the sex of the baby, and that process is called as amniocentesis. What is that? Amniocentesis. So what is amniocentesis? It is a fetal sex determination test based on the chromosomal pattern in the amniotic fluid surrounding the embryo. Very important from examination point of view. What is amniocentesis? Okay, so what is amniocentesis? A fetal sex determination test. For what? To determine the sex of the baby. How is it done? It is based on the chromosomal pattern of the in the amniotic fluid surrounding the developing embryo. So what will be the chromosomal pattern? If the baby is a boy, the chromosomal pattern will be 44 autosomes plus X and Y chromosome. Whereas if it is a female baby, it will be 44 autosomes plus X and X chromosome. So by determining whether it is XX or XY, we can find out whether the baby is a boy baby or a girl baby. But this process or this test is banned in India nowadays. What must be the reason? You all very well know, because couples normally don't want to have female babies. They want to have boy babies. Why? Because our society is a male dominant society. Okay, so as soon as the couple come to know that the baby is a female baby, they go for abortions or they go to kill the baby within the mother's womb itself. That is called as feticide. So because of this increased number of female feticides, now this amniocentesis is banned in India. So now there is no mechanism to know whether the baby is a boy baby or a girl baby. Okay, now then, but this amniocentesis is allowed in certain cases. Suppose the developing baby or the developing fetus has certain chromosomal abnormalities, right? Then amniocentesis is allowed. So amniocentesis is used to find out chromosomal abnormalities in developing embryo. It is misused when it is used to check the fetal sex. Hence it is banned in India. Why? To prevent female feticide, killing of female babies. Okay, so these are some of the steps which are used to attain reproductive health. Now, what are the features? How can we say that a society is reproductively healthy? Or what are the features that indicate better reproductive health? First one, better awareness about sex-related matters. What does it mean? So, as I've told you, if the people in a society, living in a society, if they have proper awareness about the sex-related issues, we can say that that society is reproductively healthy. Second one is increased number of medically assisted deliveries. In whichever society there are deliveries taking place in the hospitals or by with the help of medical assistance, we say that that society is reproductively healthy. Now, the same way, better postnatal care. Those societies which take care of the babies in proper way, we say that that society is reproductively healthy. Then, if a society has number of couples with small families, that society is also said to be reproductively healthy. Then, if there is a proper means by of detection and cure of sexually transmitted diseases, then also we say that that society is reproductively healthy. So these are some of the features which indicate better reproductive health. So this also you may get as a question. Name the features that indicate or mention the features which indicate a reproductively healthy society. Answer is better awareness about sex-related matters, increased number of medically assisted deliveries, better postnatal care, increased number of couples with small families, and better detection and cure of STDs. Hope it's clear? Right. And one more, decreased maternal and infant mortality rate. So that is another feature which indicates a reproductive healthy society. In a society where the maternal death rate is less, maternal mortality rate and infant mortality rate is less, we say that that society is reproductively healthy. Okay, so that is all about the steps or the features of a reproductively healthy society. Now the next topic is population explosion and birth control. You know what is population explosion? I need not explain that, right? Improved quality of what has led to population explosion? Why has the human population increased like anything? The reason for that, one is improved quality of life of people. Nowadays, people don't have any lack. They have proper food. They have proper medical care. So, because of all that, the quality of life of people has increased. Second one, we have increased health facilities, right? We have better living conditions, and all these features had an explosive impact on population explosion. So why is there a population explosion? It is because of all these reasons. What? Because of improved quality of life of people, increased health facilities, better living conditions, and decreased. One more thing is decreased. Rapid decline in death rate. Death rate has come down drastically. Why? Because of the proper health facilities that we get, expert doctors, super speciality hospitals. Because of all these, the death rate has come down. Not only that, even MMR, that is maternal mortality rate, has come down. Infant mortality rate has come down. All these, not only that, the people in the reproductive age group, it has gone very high. People in the reproductive age group, that is the age of between 20 to 40, it is very high. These are some of the reasons for population explosion. So you may get a question, what are the reasons for population explosion? What are the reasons? One is improved quality of life of people. Second one, increased health facilities. Third one, better living conditions. Fourth one, rapid decline in death rate. Then not only death rate, decline in MMR, that is maternal mortality rate, IMR, that is infant mortality rate, and also increase in population of reproductive age group. So these are some of the reasons for population explosion. So hope you understood all this. What are the reasons? Now, what are the steps by which we can overcome population explosion? First one, using various contraceptive methods. That is, in the next class we'll discuss about this, various contraceptive methods. Second one, educating people about demerits of large family. If you have a large family, what are the problems that you are going to face? By educating people about that, we can overcome the problem of population explosion. Third one, increasing the marriageable age of male and female. Earlier, child marriages were plenty, but nowadays there is an age limit. Only a girl who crosses, completes the age of 18 is allowed to get married. Otherwise, it will be a child marriage. So, child marriage is prohibited in India. And the boy should be above the age of 21. Okay. So, increasing that marriageable age group. And providing incentives to couples having one or two children. So, if you have only one children, some incentives has to be given. If you have only two children, then also some incentives have to be given. If it is more, then you will not get that incentive. Incentive means some encouragement from the government in the form of certain scholarships to the children, or in the form of certain stationery, or in the form of certain other methods. Okay, so that is providing incentives. Okay, so these are some of the steps by which we can overcome population explosion. Hope you understood what we discussed today. Okay, it's not a interesting, not very interesting topic, but you have to study this topic from for examination point of view.